गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सी प्रोग्राम, हाउ टू राइट द सी प्रोग्राम इन सी विंडो एंड हाउ टू कंपाइल इट एंड हाउ टू एग्जीक्यूट इट. इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी इनपुट आउटपुट इन सी. सो हाउ टू टेक इनपुट फ्रॉम द यूजर एंड हाउ टू प्रिंट द मैसेज ऑन आउटपुट स्क्रीन. फॉर दैट वी आर यूजिंग प्रिंटएफ एंड स्कैनएफ फंक्शन. इज इट माई वॉइस इज ऑडिबल टू ऑल? हेलो.
यस सर.
ओके ओके. सो फॉर फॉर शोइंग एन आउटपुट ऑन आउटपुट स्क्रीन वी यूज प्रिंटएफ फंक्शन. इन सी प्रोग्रामिंग प्रिंटएफ इज द वन ऑफ द मेन आउटपुट फंक्शन. द फंक्शन सेंड फॉर्मेटेड आउटपुट टू द स्क्रीन. सो यूजिंग प्रिंटएफ फंक्शन वी कैन डिस्प्ले द मैसेज ऑन द स्क्रीन. सो दिस इज द सिंपल प्रोग्राम वेयर वी इंक्लूडेड द डिरेक्टरी दैट इज stdio.h. stdio stand for standard input output directory, and all the directory files have the extension .h. It's a header files. We include this directory at heading position, so it is known as the header file. So its extension is .h. Using .h we can come to know these are the header files. So here the first line should be main. Here we must include the main function because our program starts to execute from the main function. So main function is necessary in every C program. There must main function that must be included in our program. Without main we cannot compile our program or cannot we execute the program. So our first line is integer main. So here if we use integer then we should return something. So here return 0 has returned. If we use void main, void is a data type and it's a null data type. It never return anything. So if we use void then there is no need to write return 0. This we are going to discuss in a function chapter. Just here understand that if we use void here then there is no need to return anything. If we use integer, float, double here then we should return something. So here in this program we use integer so that here we use return. Okay, then here we simply printf function and here we give the formatted string. That means what we expected on the output screen we are enclosed here in a double quote. So printf C programming on output screen we find this string display on output screen. So let's see example practically. So here is the turbo C++ icon. Double click on it. Oh, new share screen. Okay, so double click. Wait. So double click on Turbo C++ icon. After that you find this screen and click here start Turbo C++. Okay. So after that you find the blue screen window appears and here we write the program. So before writing first save the program at appropriate location. So we have to change its extension from C++, that is CPP, to C. And here we change its name with welcome 1. And its location is C turbo C3 folder / bin and / welcome 1 dot C. I click on OK. So here I find the program name with extension dot C. After that, if we can give comment here. Welcome, and here I simply write welcome program and written by or author. It's not necessary to write this line. This is for generally for the information. Okay, so our first line would be include stdio.h. And one more directory that we must added, that is include conio.h. So these both the directories are important. In our program we write integer main, right? So integer is the data type, it is also a keyword, so you find its color in white, and this is the function name, so it's a green. Okay, here curly bracket is used to show the scope of the function. So main function from this curly bracket to this, that means its scope remain from open curly bracket to close curly bracket. Whatever we write here, this is under main function. So I write here printf function, printf, and here we give the message welcome to C. Okay, every statement ends with semicolon, so here semicolon is must. If you're not giving semicolon there, then we get syntax error. After that we write the getch function, getch, get the characters. Okay, before that we must write a return zero, so return is also a keyword, so it appears in a white text. So after that we have to compile the program. To compile the program we can use compile and compile here, or we can use shortcut Alt+F9. So I click here, so here we get the two warnings and zero errors. Press any key, so I press enter key again. I run the program. To run, screen get hang. Oh, screen does not work. Maybe the system gets hang. Again, we open the code. Yes, here it is. And after that, we run the program by pressing Ctrl F9. So here, instead of writing void main, I write integer main, I write void main and comment the code. Okay. So here we get the output, welcome to C. Okay. So if we want to use integer main, we can use it. But if we want to view the output, we have to just press F5. So here we get the output. To clear the screen, we use CLRSTR function to clear the screen. So we get, so here program get compiled, and we can view the output by pressing Alt F5, and here we get the output. Okay, and if we use void here, then there is no need to write return statement, but we require getch, and here we get the output. welcome to see. If we want to change the message, welcome to FRCS. We can compile it and run the program. Here we get the output. Welcome to FYCS. So this is our program. Let's move to theory again. So how does this program works? A valid C program must contain the main function. So main function is must there. The code execution begins from the start of the main function. So the first line of execution is main. So we must write the main function here. The printf is the library function, sends formatted output to the screen. The function prints the string inside the quotation. So print, the use of printf function is to send whatever the string or the integer value, whatever the value is enclosed in the bracket, forwarded to the output screen. The function prints the string inside the quotation. The use printf in our program, we need to include studio.io.h header files using the hash include studio.io.h. That means to use the printf function, the printf function is written in a studio.io.h file. So we must include this file in our program. This directory file we must include it. So if you are not included here, then we cannot use printf statement here or printf function here. The return zero statement inside the main function is the exit status of the program and it's optional. So here we use integer, for that we use return. If you use void here, then there is no need of return statement. So in first example, we print the string on output string. In second example, we are going to print integer value. So for that, we are going to go to the code window. We maximize the window by pressing Alt Enter. Then we click on File and New. Here we write the program. So I write first hash include stdio.h. After that, hash include conio.h. Okay. We save the program. Here give the name integer value, or we do the program of addition. So I write add.c. So after that we write the function void main. Okay, here we write void main and we define three integers here, a, b, c. So the data type of variables, these are nothing but the variable that we discuss in the next lecture. First just understand that these are the variables where we store some values in it. Okay, so I specify some value. For a it's a 10, for b is equal to 20. Okay, after that we do some addition here. So c is equal to a plus b. So I store some value in it, and before that we assign value 0 to c. Okay, c is equal to a plus b, and after that I want to print this addition. So for printing I use printf function, and here I give the message, the addition of a and b is, here we specify the formatted output. We want the decimal value here or integer value here. For integer we write here %d, and then we give comma, and whatever the output we want we write here the integer. That is the integer variable, that is the C. And after that we write getch function and program close. We save this program, compile it, and then run. To run, we use control F9. So here we get the addition, A and B is 30. Okay, so we have to clear the screen. To clear the screen, we write here CLR SCR. So it must write after the variable declaration. So I write here CLR SCR, and then again we run the program. The addition of A and B is 30. So in this program we define the three variables A comma B comma C. A for first value, B for the second value, and C is used to store the addition of two numbers. So whenever the addition has done, we give the printf message to print on output screen. So whatever the addition has been done, we store in a variable C, and that display on the output screen. The addition of A and B is percent %DC. So here we want to display integer value. For that we write percent %D. So this is the format to print value. If you want to print string, then we can simply write in double quote. And if you want to print the value, we write it outside the double quote. So memorize this thing. So in this program here, it's a simple program where one variable is defined with data type integer and value is assigned to it is 5. After that, it simply print the value by using printf function. Printf number is equal to percent %D test integer. So the value of test integer is 5, it will display here. So here percent %D is used for the print integer value. So number is equal to percent %D and test integer, the output is number is equal to 5. We use percent %D format specifier to print integer types. Here the percent %D inside the quotation will be replaced by the value test integer. Okay, next float and double. If you want, float is the value with decimal, and double is also, we can write integer as well as float value in double, but its range is more than integer. So here we define two variables, number one and number two, with the values 13.5 and 12.4 respectively. After that we print its value. Here for float we use percent %F and for double we use LF. Okay, let's see with practical. So in this program we just modify it. So here we write instead of integer we use float here, and we change its the value with 0.0, 10.5 and 20.5. Okay, after that we do the addition and print the addition of an A and B. So here we use float, so instead of percent %D we use LF. Okay, sorry, percent %F, and we save the program. And we compile it using Alt F9. And then we run it. So here we get the output. The addition of A and B is 13.0000. So the value of C is So value of c is addition of a and b that we store in a variable c, and after that we print the addition by using the printf function, and here we use formatter as %f, and if it is double, then instead of float here we define the data type double abc, and all the remain same, only here we make the modification that lf, and we compile the program and we get the desired output. We change its value with .20.5 and .20.8. Again we compile and get the output 41.30. Okay, so this is for printing double. Next one, print characters. To print characters, we simply write here %c. Okay, here we define the character with data type char and the variable name is chr. In that we assign the character in single quote a. If we want to specify the character, use single quote, and if we want to display the string, use double quote, and after that we print the character using %c data formatter, and here we specify the variable name, that is chr, where the value a is stored, and after execute the program we get the output character is equal to a. Okay, so here we again print something. So here we define character s is equal to in single quote s. Okay, and after here we print the character is equal to %c comma, and here we print s. Okay, and ends with semicolon. Compile the program and run, then we get the character is c and the addition of a and b is 41.3. suppose if you want to modify this, just simply write here /n and then compile, so the addition is come on new line because of /n. Okay, so next function is scanf. Everyone got understand this, no? Hello?
Yes, sir.
If you have any doubt, any issues, let me know. Okay? Purnima? Hello, Purnima? Yes, sir. Samasta hai na saga? Arbina? Yes, sir. Arbina?
Yes, sir.
Fast hot nahi hai na? अथर्व, इशरत, सफा, शुभम आणि जिशान, काही इशू असेल तर लगेच विचारा, नाहीतर मग चॅट बॉक्स वर टाका. चल नेक्स्ट बघू आपण. नेक्स्ट वन इज स्कॅनएफ फंक्शन. सो हियर वी प्रिंट द कॅरेक्टर, आफ्टर दॅट ASCII value. ASCII value is nothing but the value of character. Whenever we type A, it does not go directly to the computer. It converted into ASCII number. So every character has specific ASCII value. So that we are going to discuss in this program. So before that, we must know about the scanf function. Yes. Okay, scanf. We discuss integer output, float and double output, then character we print. Okay, after that, here we start with c input. So So now just we discussed printf function. Printf function is used to print the value or the string on output screen, right? So input, C input is used to accept the input from the user. So for that we use scanf function. So here is the program. Here we define the test integer variable with integer data type. Then we printf, enter an integer. So this message will display on a output screen. But at that time user gives some input, and that input we must be read. To read it, we use scanf function. Scanf %d, and. Here we use and because the value of variable store in a memory, and is used to specify its address. So here we use and. So printf %d, and test integer, and then we print the value. Print number is test integer. Let's see live. So this is your output screen. So in last program, we define the value here. Instead of define it, we get the input from the user. So I commented these two lines. So I give here message. Enter A and B in double quote. After that we use scanf function. Scanf. So scanf function, we write like this. Here we use %d, %d, because we want to get two values, right? Comma. And here we use and A and B. Better to take it separately. So enter A. And here we scan first value using %A. Then we write printf. Here we write enter B. Then we scan this value using scanf function. %d, and B. Okay. And after that we do the addition. C is equal to A plus B. Changes data type with integer. So we can use here %d. After that we do the addition and print its addition. So here we must write %d as it's a integer data type. We compile the program. One error we get. What is that? Statement missing. Oh, so here we forget to give semicolon. And we compile the program. Enter A, for example 12. Enter B, for example 30, 12. And we get the output. The addition of A and B is 24. So in this program, we get the integer value using scanf function. So here we write the %d, and A and B. Okay. Same like that, we can accept float value also. Just modify. So instead of giving here integer, we write here float. and here we modify with percent. Instead of percent D, we use percent F because using float value. And here we change with percent F. All the remain is same. Enter A 12.5. Enter B 12.9, and we get the output. Addition is 25.4. Okay, so we can get the float value also. We can get double value also. Okay. So remaining we'll discuss in the next section. Because only 2 minutes are remaining. So we will, in next lecture, we will discuss some more examples on this. So here we end this session. If you have any doubt, any query regarding this, feel free to contact me on my WhatsApp number. Okay. Thank you.